just to be clear, there's probably going to be some parts in this recollection that seem a little jumbled or off. I just want to let you know my memory of these past few months has been, I don't want to say trash because I don't consume alcohol, but yeah, sure, we'll call it trashed. Personally, I don't think I'm the best person to retell this story. I mean, I started it, sure, but you can find so many more people involved with this that can tell you. You can go ask Eliza, she's next door, and she'll probably give you a much better rendition of the story, even though she only knows half of it. But if you insist that I tell this, then it's personally fine with me. I got nothing to do for a while. So yeah, this is basically the story of how I tried and failed to create this edgy capstone short. Do I have the script even? Like, I think I threw it away, but here it is. Okay. I tried to make this, I don't know if you can see, there we go. Look at this. Don't even read this. It just, Jimmy embraces Annette like the childhood mother of, should burn that. So yeah, this is a film some people like, everyone else seems to hate, including myself. So yeah, let us relive this traumatic but redeeming, enlightening experience right now by flashing back 3 months from now. This is stupid. You can't make this movie. What? There is no way the school is gonna allow you to make this film. What's wrong with it?
What's wrong with it? The first line of dialogue is fuck the school.
So what? Kids say the F word all the time.
I'm not in movies.
That doesn't matter. This is supposed to be an accurate metaphor of today's American youth.
Oh, accurate, huh? Okay, so let me get this straight. Your idea of an average average male of today's American society is, someone who gets high, goes on a psychotic episode with zombies, and then his alcoholic girlfriend beats him up.
You ruined me, Jimmy!
How much schoolwork did you skip to write this?
About 2.5 weeks.
Of all the people I could be reflections of, I had to get a nutcase. No, that's brilliant, really. Just thank you.
Oh, that's better. Okay, so this is your subconsciousness here. I know you haven't been using me a lot, but if you want my opinion on the matter, scrap the bloody project entirely and write down a romantic comedy. I mean, you're great at telling a well-written joke.
Yeah, I can tell a joke, but with a well-rounded character of the opposite sex, I'm screwed.
Make it a gay romantic comedy, then.
Oh my god, that's brilliant!
Okay, you know what, screw you two.
I'm sticking with the script.
I've already got a cast and crew together shooting some of it, and you know what? This will be good for the local movie audience. They need to listen to what I have to say instead of those other pansy filmmakers in my school who have no idea how to write or direct or anything for that matter. The audience, they need more excitement edge in their movies.
You realize that every adult with a kid who has a drug problem will want to kill you.
Did you cut the script?
What are you talking about?
What do you mean, what am I talking about? The ending is, it's not in the script.
Well, yeah, I haven't finished it.
Alright, I know what you're thinking, but just listen to me.
You gave me an unfinished copy of the script.
You are shooting the frickin' movie! while sailing on a premature dinghy.
Yes, I've been a little lazy on the script. Yes, I've been procrastinating on schoolwork as well. But if you just trust me to film this with people who know how to film and act, I'm pretty sure...
Jason, you okay in there?
Yeah, Dad, everything's peachy.
Okay.
Jason Millard, this is Book. She will be the main actress for our film, and this is the first time you've done, like, makeup for a big student film.
I've dabbled in other projects. Do you know Paul Molini?
Yeah, he got you to work for him?
It wasn't anything big, just a scene where his face melted off.
Oh, I've seen that. That movie was pretentious as hell, but I love the makeup in that scene.
Thank you.
Like, you'll do perfect for today's zombie makeup.
Wait, we're filming one of the hallucination scenes?
Yeah.
You told us we were filming the first kiss scene.
No, I said we were shooting in the parking lot today.
Yeah, doesn't that take place in the parking lot?
No, I moved it into the school cafeteria. It was in the semi-final draft of the script I gave you earlier.
Through text?
Through email!
Why the hell would you send it to my email? I never use it.
It's more professional!
Jason, I have to go to a concert after this, and I didn't plan on going to it looking like a bloody zombie!
Look, we're gonna be done with this shoot in like 30 minutes. You can wipe it off afterwards.
Jason? You know what? Screw it. I want to be an actress. I should prepare myself for this.
Well, good. I'm glad you're using logic for once.
You're welcome. I've gotta go get my purse.
Does this usually happen when you're together?
Oh, all the time. Oh, finally.
Is that Benny?
Yeah, somehow Jason got him to be in the shit. Have you talked to him before?
We have chemistry together.
Oh, lucky you.
He looks amazing.
Damn straight.
Benny!
Jason, come here!
Thank goodness you're here. Brooke is driving me crazy.
Well, you ready for me to tame her?
Oh, no. We're shooting one of the hallucination scenes.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, that's why I told you not to shave.
Well, here.
Fantastic. Eliza, could you come over here and make Benny look like a crackhead? Like, give him baggy eyes or something?
Benny, this is Eliza, our makeup artist for the film. Eliza, this is Benny. He's Benny.
Pleasure meeting you.
Meet me over over there.
Great, the first time you two meet and you immediately freak her out. Where were you, by the way?
Do number 31 on the list. Eat fast food with the person that serves you. It's crazy. Duane and I met this 50-year-old Buddhist lady. She had like 5 gold teeth and a bunch of the signed Ringo Starr stuff. Well, not like the albums, but like actually signed stuff.
Oh my god. Tell me, is kissing every girl on the hand on your list by chance?
Number 4. Gives them more meaning to their day.
Yeah, well, I think she proved you wrong.
Jason!
One sec.
Have you memorized your lines?
Yep.
Are you okay with the dialogue?
Oh yeah, it's fine.
Benny, don't lie to me.
I'm not joking, it's okay. It's heavy.
Now, for the character of Annette in this scene in particular, she's not the perky girlfriend we saw at the beginning of the film. She sort of acts more like Jimmy's evil subconsciousness. Like, it sounds like she's there, but she's not really there. She sort of sounds like she's in control of Jimmy, but she also has this feeling of being violated on the inside. Now, it's fine if you can't do that, the last thing I said, but I trust that you'll act that out well. So, yeah, is there anything else you want to add to that?
What?
Did you think of anything else besides what I said when reading the script?
Oh, the script? No, I haven't read it yet. I thought I would just remember my lines on the spot to give me more energy. I find it better than directors rehearsing with their actors just weeks before shooting anything. I find it less time-consuming. Did you want to rehearse with us?
No,
or...
no, it's fine. Whatever works for you as an actress.
Okay, is the camera all set up?
Yes.
Does the shot look good? Can you see him?
Yes.
Okay, okay. Scene 17, take one. Action! Okay, cut. Hang on, Dwayne. Do you remember what I told you to do for this shot? Move the camera back.
Why would I be moving it back? He's already far away.
You know, it's like it's a cinematic metaphor. Like, Jimmy feels like he's moving forward to get some coke, but it turns out he remains in the sort of same position throughout the whole shot. You got it?
Yeah.
All right, get back on the camera. Benny, we're running it again. Scene 17, take, two. And action. All right, cut. Dwayne, you're not moving the camera.
I was going to.
The moment I say action, you immediately pull the camera back.
All right.
Action!
Shoot! Ah! Is the camera all right?
Yeah, the camera's fine. Oh, shoot. Jace, I think my hand's bleeding.
Did you call me Jace?
Can we please get to my part after this take?
Yeah, sure, go. Cut, okay, we're moving on.
The camera was a little shaky when I placed it
we're
down.
We're on a schedule, Dwayne. We gotta move, for God's sakes. Let's just... 17D, take two, action.
I'm all made up the way you treat yourself. All pale and ruined.
Cut.
What did I do?
You slurred.
Anne, you're the only person left on this earth that I don't hate.
Sorry. All pale and ruined. Just the way you...
Wait, what are you doing?
I'm gonna get a close-up of Benny's ear.
Did I tell you to get a close-up of his ear?
No, I just think, being the director of photography...
Look, if you keep it at the same...
And how?
My hands are numb.
No! You'll see! You all see! Just what I am capable of!
And we are done for tonight! You know, I know that these first few days of filmmaking have been tough for just about all of you.
I'm fine with it.
That's a spirit, Benny. But, in all seriousness, I am just so proud that all of you, especially you, Eliza, is able to shape yourselves into a good cast and crew that just knows how to make movies.
No.
Wait, Dwayne, what's wrong?
Oh, God.
What's wrong?
The microphone wasn't recording. I forgot to turn it on for the whole shoot.
Eliza, you want me to drive you home?
You can do it. You can do it. Thank you.
Eliza, this is Jason Millard. Listen, can you... I have a quick question to ask you about the film. Are you busy? Okay. Are you sure you're busy? Like,
you sound a bit disinterested.
Don't worry, fire away.
Okay, let me figure out how I'm going to phrase this. Okay, if you were an over-exaggerated dream version of your ex-boyfriend just after he got done going on a psychedelic acid trip, would you want to end up shooting him in the head or drowning him in a river? That made no sense to you, did it? Eliza. Yeah, it's the ending to the script. No, I'm sorry for calling. I've just been sitting on my ass all day on a computer trying to figure out how to end this stupid script. I don't know whether to go for the cliched sad ending or the over-exaggerated Disney-esque happy ending. No, I have no idea how to end it. I've been, like, I couldn't sleep for, like, 20 hours because it's been driving me bananas.
Well, do you need me to come over and help you?
What are you talking about? It's, like, 10 p.m. at night. You don't find that late? Okay, granted, a lot of people don't find that late, but still... No, my parents aren't home. They're out with friends. Like, that's another reason I don't want you coming into my dreary home. If, like, any robbers... come in to rob my empty house. I don't want you to be my damsel in distress being held at knife point while I have to get naked, put on camo, and go Rambo on their asses.
Do you always think like this?
No, I'm just incredibly tired.
Well, for one thing, I don't think it would be any sort of problem for me to just come over to your house, and I don't think there are going to be any robbers poking around, so, where do you live again?
The cul-de-sac of Dunwell Court. Eliza? Hello?
Oh, sorry. No, but it would be no problem. It's just a 5-minute drive. My mom's fine with taking me
Don't
over.
Tell your mother!
What? I told her about the film. She's totally supportive of it, and I think she knows your parents, too. What's wrong?
I specifically told Dwayne to tell everybody that don't tell your parents that you're making this film. Like, look, I already have enough problems as it is. I don't need some adult- Jesus!
Talking to someone?
Forgive me, Father, pardon my French. But how did you get here so fast? Like, I thought you'd
Jason,
come-
Jason! I live right behind you.
You- Oh my God.
Did you seriously not know that we're neighbors?
No, I- That's- Right, that's right! You know, last afternoon I swore I saw your face before. You're the daughter of the Pemskis!
Yeah!
Oh my god, my mom loves your parents. They're so sweet. Your dog. What's the name of your dog? I gotta know. He's so sweet.
Pablo?
Yeah,
really?
Yeah! You know, he always comes by this fence. I try to pet him, but he keeps biting my hand.
Oh my god.
I think he infected me once. I just really can't believe that you're my neighbor. Oh, shoot, I should have given you a ride home.
Oh, no, it's totally fine. Brooke took me home, and I knew you were pissed off about everything that
went
down.
Don't remind me about that evening. Just...
Yeah, I'm sorry about all this.
Yeah, it's a mess. Well, at least someone's getting a kick out of the production.
Who's that?
Benny.
Benny?
Yeah, the holy optimist Benny. Well, I'm glad I found this out sooner than later. Good night.
Jason. Do you still want me to come over and help?
Sure. Come in whenever you're ready. The door will be unlocked.
I feel so unprepared right now. I should have told you when I wanted you to come over.
You really didn't have to make me hot chocolate. But
so what? I wanted a hot chocolate myself. Like, I just want to make you feel comfortable. I don't want to let my stench of failure consume you.
Now what are you doing?
I'm putting on music.
Jason.
There's a blanket all over here. Do you want me to...
Jason, I'm fine.
Sorry, it's just...
You don't have to be sorry.
I just want to make this feel as comfortable as possible. Like I've just had a rough night and I just want you to feel comfortable.
What music is this?
Oh. Girl, I should have told you what music you
want. No, just, what is it?
It's something by Benny Goodman. It's riffing at the Ritz, some popular 30s and 40s jazz, I don't know.
Do you always listen to songs like this?
Yeah, just, I mean, it beats the technicality of today's music. I'm gonna shut this off.
No, Jason, it's fine, I like it.
All right, let's get the script over with. One thing before we start.
Jason.
It's about the script. It's about the script. Do you like it?
Yeah, it's really interesting. It's, captivating.
More interesting than Paul Mullaney's script?
Of course, it's more ambitious.
Really?
Yeah, it feels like, a parody of one of those anti-drug PSAs they play on, like, the first day of school. But it's still relatable. Like the dialogue all feels supernatural, and the scenes and the characters are all supernatural, too. It's not boring.
Do you take creative writing?
No.
Well, geez, I think for a guy who hasn't made tons of movies, you're a pretty good writer.
It's directing you kind of suck at.
Not to say you can't improve, but it's just... Well, if you want my image of a director, I would imagine someone who would be... who would make a lot of small talk with everyone. They would ask about everyone's day, maybe like, I don't know, pick them up Chipotle or something. It's like, they would always make a big fuss about the actors and always tell them like exactly what they want. And no matter how annoying they are, and like... Well, like, a director can be a perfectionist. They just need to, like, lighten up and be more human, you know? Am I just babbling nonsense?
No, this is, as demeaning as this is, it's always helpful to have some input from someone else.
No, I don't think all your directing is, like, mediocre, but when you're directing certain attractive, possibly single actors, you bring out, like, something unique in them.
You really think so?
Yeah, when Benny was acting yesterday, he just felt like so human, like so layered. So layered that I just want to know like everything about him. So what are his interests?
Well, Benny is just an exception to the cast, and I do mean exception. It's just... I tell you, he's one of the most fascinating people I've ever met, honestly. He just has that power of turning everything you say, as shitty as it is, into solid gold. I hate to say it, but I think that bucket list of his is really improving his charm.
Is the bucket list that long piece of paper he's always carrying around?
Mm-hmm.
Is it for a project or a class or a...
No, it's just something he made up one night. He just wrote down a bunch of stuff he wanted to do before senior year, and he's sticking to it.
And do you know the reason why he made it?
I have a guess. Don't quote me on this one, but I think it comes indirectly from the people he was stuck hanging out with in middle school.
Now, it's a scientific fact for most American kids that the shift from middle school to high school is a miraculous, emotional, life-changing moment in one's life. In Benny's case, I think he never got to experience that firsthand. The first 2 years he was there, he could have hung out with a whole variety of people, all those jocks, outsiders, artists, and nerds running amok. But Benny never got a chance to branch out, as he was stuck with the same loners club he joined in middle school. No matter how desperate Benny was to step out of his bubble, the slimy soap just pulled him back in. After 4 long school years, Benny was sick of his friends and their awful habits. Well, never mind, I mean, they weren't awful. Sure, they helped him study and get straight A's, but that was pretty much it. That's basically little to nothing in his world. I figured out this life lesson after junior year that if you only go to school just to get an education, then you're officially not a real human being. Well, I think Benny was one step ahead of me during his junior year. Because one miraculous day, he walked up to his friends, plopped down a giant piece of paper on their table, and said,
"I'm escaping this purgatory. Who wants to join me?"
Okay, that's probably not what he actually said, but if I was in that situation, that's what I would say. Oh, the bucket list. How can I even describe something absolutely perfect, yet bonkers? Every event was written down with such pristine detail, from the day an event should take place and how random it was when paired with the other events that week. For example, one week went as follows. Monday, binge work on this week's schoolwork. Tuesday, light wine karaoke night. Wednesday, skipping class for hangover recovery workout. I'm not joking with that one. For every sin Benny committed against the school, whether it be drinking or skipping class, there was always something he gave back to him, whether it be acting in the plays, singing in glee club, or just giving almost everyone in the school something to feel good about.
That's where I come into the picture. I was number 16 on his list. I think he titled it, "Work with Jason Miller, no matter how crazy it gets."
Why do you want to work with you? Did you ever talk to him before?
No, he just wanted to act in my movie.
I just find it so incredible, that list.
You know, I used to find that piece of paper incredibly stupid.
Why?
Well, I mean, if you gotta pull something off like that, you've gotta be, like, on top of it. Now, I'm not calling Benny out or anything, but I've seen Benny plenty of times, and when he gets going with something, he does not stop to catch your hand. Like, I want to see what else he's doing besides making my movie, but to do that, I gotta catch him at 100 different parties just to catch his attention. I mean, it's like every day he's like in his own little dimension or something.
How the heck do you think he finds the time to get through all that stuff?
My guess is that he goes around at night sucking away people's time while they're asleep and then using it like some sort of time wizard.
Either that or he does all these things in a room where the clock never moves. Do you ever feel like that when
What did you say?
What?
I said something about a time wizard. Like, what did you say after that?
In a room where the clocks never move?
Clock never moves. Stuck in a room where the clock never moves. Interior scene. Empty white hospital room where the clock stands to... I found it!
What did you find?
The ending to the script, the whole reason I pulled you into this awful After the acid trip, Jimmy suddenly glares into the camera, both menacingly and timidly. He is straitjacketed in an empty white hospital room, or green screen into it. In that room, the only prop that looks down at him is a circular clock that never moves. Cut to exterior field, silhouetted Jimmy walking pleasantly away from the camera until he decides to fall flat on his face, making the camera lose him in the thick meadows. That was his young golden soul walking away from Jimmy's body, ambiguous to whether it will return to him or wake up at all to bring Jimmy back into the meadows of its childhood. Yes! It's sudden, depressing, somewhat hopeful, and I don't have to shoot any of it with Brooke. I found it! Yes! Thank you, Heavenly Lord, amen, I have found the finale to my script.
Jeez, Jason, are you okay?
Oh, Eliza, do you have any idea how long I've been waiting to finish that script? Do you know how much work I need to hug you right now. Can I do that?
What?
Can I hug you right now? Like, are you okay with that? I just need to... It's done! I gotta text Benny. It's done! It's finally done! Oh, shoot.
What now?
It's Benny. He texted me like an hour ago asking if I wanted to come over to something tonight. Oh well, I got the script done. Like, that's all that matters to me.
Well, don't you want to text him back?
Nah. For all I know, he could probably be doing something boring. You're hungover. No, Benny, I'm not mad at you, but what the hell were you thinking?
I'm so sorry, Jason. They're serving drinks, and I got caught up in the crossfire, the energy, and the music, and... Oh, God. It was a junior mistake.
I should have known better.
damn straight you should have.
Jason?
What?
You sound really pissed off.
Oh, who, me? Pissed off? No, not at all. What do we gotta get pissed off about? The main actor of my film, that's due a month from now, just purposely got himself sick and canceled his big day where he's supposed to film this big hallucination scene with a crew of about 10 other people who can't make it any other day, even though we're already behind schedule. No, it's completely fine! What the hell is there to get pissed off about?
Don't yell at me. Ugh.
Sorry, Benny, I had like 3 hours of sleep last night.
What?
I said, remind me to cross off everything on my list that might involve drinking. I don't want this to ruin your...
Art. Ben. Okay, I'm gonna hang up now. Good night, sweet prince.
Good night.
Dwayne, it's Jason.
So Benny called in sick today. Yeah, he called me. So the big filming day is canceled. So I want you to just text out to all the extras that it's just canceled. I don't know, we'll shoot it some other weekend, I don't know. Oh yeah, also tell Brooke that it's... Actually, no, just, you know what, new plan, tell all the extras that today, the filming is canceled today, and don't tell Brooke. I still want her to be here and shoot some of her scenes. Just trust me, like, are you still open today? Okay, well, I'll see you at 9, and make sure that the camera...
It's driving Jimmy mad. It is. He stopped paying attention to his family, to me. We were walking through the park one night, all cold and dreary. I had no coat on. I was lying. It was freezing, and Jimmy wouldn't let me have his coat. He didn't even walk near me. In the cold, dark night, I could see his back, caught in the lights. He was walking past me, going down a path I can't follow. And it broke my heart. He's trapped.
It's good.
So is that all you need me for today?
Yeah.
See ya.
Right.
Dwayne, don't forget, next week we're gonna shoot the...
Oh, hey, has Dwayne left?
Yeah. Ed, sit down for a sec. I gotta talk to you about something.
I don't want you working on my film anymore. It's not that I don't like your acting, it's just... I mean, it's great, the acting, but... everything else about you just... drives me crazy. Just the inept thought process of what you go through for thinking how to make a movie is sufferingly awful. And I think it's best that after this we just go our separate ways. Later this week I'll tell everyone that you just... got an acting job or something.
So, let me get this straight. This whole day of shooting scenes without Benny, that was just...
A quicker way to get you off my set. Yes, you hit it right on the big nose.
So yeah, that's basically it. Thanks for coming here. If you want, the front door's right there for you to...
No, shut up. If you think this is over, think again, douchebag. What the hell makes you think I wasn't putting my work into this project?
Just about everything you've done.
You don't think I wanted to really add this to my resume? You don't think I wanted to be in a film class to study more than just all those shitty terms on shots, mise en scène, all that crap? No, I just wanted to act in your film because I had nothing better to do. I only did it for the lols. Not to get anything helpful or interesting for my future. Not that I would have, since you've ruined that experience for all of us, Jason.
Now what is that supposed to mean?
I mean that you are a terrible director. You think of everybody on your set as nothing but a tool for your dumb movie. Oh, except for Benny, who you take turns sucking dicks with each other all day. And back on that dumb movie, yeah, Jason, it's shit. Even an autistic fuckface like yourself could have figured out sooner or later, you can't make a movie about a piece of wood getting addicted to drugs. You're just like that filmmaking douche last year, Joe Stutman. Yet that shitty movie he made about a kid trying to overcome his alcohol addiction, that's a million times better than your dumb idea, because at least he knew how teens acted. You're making us act nothing like real people. Not that you ever hang out with any. You know one thing this so-called bitch has that you don't? Actual effort in her craft. I bet I could have turned this turd into a Sundance sensation if you just gave me one chance behind the camera like I originally wanted. But no, you had to bask in your giant turd for everyone else to see. You are a horrible person, Jason. You always will be. You irrational, autistic piece of shit.
I mean, I knew she would blow up in my face, but that was kind of ridiculous, wouldn't you say?
In other news, 5% of the polar bears living in Antarctica were transferred today to a new concentration camp in Brazil. We have been told by outside sources that their diet is going to be of rotten fish from under the fridge and Cheerios from under the couch. If you want to find out how you can help stop this madness, you can't. Outside sources also told us the concentration camp is guarded by 30 eating tigers. This was reported to us by the Navajo John DeMo, who was sadly mauled to death last week by the tigers when asking for their interview. As for the polar bears, we now believe there is no hope for these poor life forms in the future. They will all be missed.
Thanks, Gary. In other news, local high school math teacher Mr. Blecker committed suicide last week by jumping in front of an unexpecting student's VW facade, going 35 miles per hour down the one-way street in the front of the school. The reason for Blecker's suicide continues to be investigated, as private eyes continue to bombard Mr. Blecker's wife and son, who won't let them into their house. Rumor has it they're packing their belongings and moving to Mexico this following week. This is about the best picture our news team could get from the scene of the accident. It proved very difficult due to many students crowding around the dead body and using their phones to take a picture of him just minutes after his demise. Reporters on the scene peeped around the students and noted that the most frequent app on their phone used to take the photos was Snapchat.
Are you ready?
Yeah, are you?
Kinda.
Hey, look at me. Just try to remember what I told you about directing. I believe in you.
They're coming.
Jason!
Don't touch me! What? Is this everyone?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, I'd like to thank all of Dwayne's friends who were able to come here to finally finish this film. It's been a long time.
Whoa.
I'm fine. Okay. Don't touch that! Hey, stop. Put that back.
Are you paying for our lunches?
No.
Okay, fuck, where was I? I know we had to shift this date around due to certain setbacks, but if we... Look, the quicker we get this done, the more invigorating the end product will be, okay?
Woo!
Okay, I'm just gonna take that as an okay. Okay, so let's get started. Benny, we're gonna shoot the first kiss scene. Everyone else just chill for a sec for now. But you got people to draw on? For God's sakes.
Chick Shack across town. It's part of his bucket list.
Number 46, get the first ultra spice chick combo of the year.
Benny's gonna pay for all our lunches.
Number 47, food's all on me?
We're just gonna be gone for like 40 minutes, is that alright?
No, it's not alright. What about Eliza? She has to put makeup on all your faces.
Well, she's coming with us.
Just come with us, Jason. How can you resist free chicken?
I'll tell you how. First I say no, and then second I tell you all to get over here. We got a schedule to keep.
We need lunch.
Yeah.
Jason, we have all afternoon. We'll be fine.
No, it won't be fine. It ruins the schedule.
So? Just change it.
Change? Do you know how impossible that... I'm gonna bring the schedule out here. Just hang on. Let me show you how impossible it is to freaking change the schedule. They're just supposed to make...
What's going on? What are we doing?
Schedule key. Right here, right there.
Oh, that actually does work.
Hey! Hey, you slackers, get back here!
Sorry, Jason. You're only a junior once. Hey, I'll tell you what. Even though you're not gonna eat anything, I'll still buy you what Dwayne's getting.
Benny, you charming bastard!
Well, now I'm hungry.
That's so hot. It's so hot.
Well, drink the milk, baby. That's why I bought it. Hey, dude, save some for the rest of us.
I'm fine.
These chicks weren't as spicy as they were as last year.
They always change the recipe at the wrong time. What do you think?
It's not too spicy.
I guess Dwayne's the only baby of the group.
Where are the napkins? So you're pretty committed to this bucket list.
Yeah, that's an understatement. I mean, I did have to take a couple of the crazy things off because that incident that happened last week.
Well, what's the craziest thing on it now?
I have to be honest with you, probably this. Or probably what I've planned for tonight. It's this whole marathon of dancing, partying, and just driving all over the place. I might not do it though, because, you know, I might do it if Jason can come. He's that guy that I just want to add to the party to give it that extra oomph.
Really?
Yeah, I mean, he's that guy that you look at his face and you're like, I want this kid in my life more. It's kind of sad. He sits at these lunch tables alone, just looks discontent with himself. I feel like if someone would really see him, like, people would like him more.
Well, do you think I could come too?
Maybe. But if that involves you bringing Jason, immediately yes.
I'll see what I can do.
So, tell me about my acting. Like in Jason's film, is it believable?
Oh, it's sensational.
Stop.
No, it's
no, man.
It's so dramatic.
It's good.
Underclassmen are just so generous. Move.
What? What's going on? Oh my god!
Hey, lady, what's in those grocery bags?
What?
I said, what's in those bags?
Oh, just cans of soup.
Wow, you must have a pretty great physique to be carrying those bags at that age. And to that I say, mwah!
Thank you.
That was so nice of you, Benny.
I think we all felt touched.
Oh, thanks. What's wrong? Something on my face?
You elbowed my face.
I did? Where?
Here.
There. Now it's even. Hey! Dwayne, you think it's cool if I drive to Jason's?
Yeah, sure.
I wanted to bark at the car, but I thought it'd be too ridiculous.
Annette, you don't understand. I feel so free right now. It's like nothing can touch me. I want you to join me on this journey. You look cold?
God dang it, Benny.
What?
What is the last line you've seen this scene?
You look cold?
But there, you did again!
What did I do again?
You're saying you look cold as a question. It's supposed to be a statement.
Yeah, I know.
No, you don't know. You've been saying it as a question for 5 takes now.
What does it matter? It can be a question.
No, it can't be a question. You cold. That is a question. You are asking
Jason,
someone if you...
It's okay. I'll fix it next time.
Okay, thank you, Benny. Other than that, great acting.
Okay, we're running it again. Quiet on set.
I want you to join me on this journey. You look cold.
Oh my god. You literally don't know you're doing it, do you?
Why doesn't he just change the line to, you cold, so it's correct?
No, he has to say, you look cold. It establishes the supernatural motif of the story. It's like, Benny is sensing some unique psychic fear from Annette that might have come from the coke, when in reality, the drugs are fake, so he's just going crazy with fake power, but actually Annette is actually cold and afraid of him, so it's double irony.
I know this is off topic, but I still don't understand why Brooke can't be here to shoot the scenes with Benny.
Dwayne, for the last time, Brooke cannot make it to the set. Her head exploded. Benny, next take, just say you cold instead of you look cold. Got it?
Yep.
Okay.
Join me on this journey. You cold.
Now you say it as a statement?
Yeah, isn't it supposed to be like that?
I'm done. Fuck you! All of you, you charlatans!
You enjoying this movie, everybody? Because I'm not.
I'm a failure to the great filmmaking gods before me. Kubrick is dancing in pain. Bunuel's eating his own rotten liver. Hemingway has an eternal headache.
Jason? How long did you sleep last night?
I don't know. About half an hour.
Half an hour?
I'm not fit to be a film director. I'm just a fartsy, procrastinating shit of a chicken.
Jason? Look at me. Just look at me.
Really hard to do right now.
Listen, we're getting through this together. I know all these problems seem to never end, but they will. You have to end them. Now go out there.
Can't I just cry for 5 more minutes?
Get out!
Okay!
Benny's brains are on the menu. That's what you signed up for. You can look for it in the con.
What the hell did you say to him up there?
All right, everybody go to Eliza for makeup.
I'm allergic to makeup.
Camera rolling.
Sure.
Scene. Whatever.
action.
Oh, no! Help! God! Oh.
Cut! Let's run that again!
Action!
Cut! Okay, Sam.
For God's sakes, action! Did I tell you to act like a pansy, Rachel? Stop moving the camera!
I don't care anymore. Just go. Do the thing.
Jason Miller. Up here.
I thought you were dead.
Of course I am. But that shouldn't stop you from doing your math homework. You haven't turned anything into my class for 2 months.
Do you mind leaving? I'm kind of in the middle of doing something important here.
I will leave when you actually do your homework.
What the hell do you care? You said all that homework was meaningless, remember?
Yeah, but you still gotta do it. We teachers force you to do the homework, and in turn, the school forces us to continue being teachers. Jeez Louise, Jason. Why can't you just suffer like the rest of us?
I got a splinter from the tree. It hurt!
Oh my God, what the fuck? Why did you do that?
I didn't do anything.
Are you kidding me?
What are you talking about?
Jason,
are you okay?
You
look sick.
We gotta reshoot everything. It wasn't in focus.
It wasn't in focus? What does that matter?
What does that matter? Everything! It looks like somebody shoved their greasy ass all over the lens. It looks crummy.
I want it to look crummy.
Yeah, but not in the good way. We gotta reshoot it.
Can't you just fix it in post?
Isn't no, we like can't fix it in post. So just focus in every shoot, you idiot! You just broke the fucking camera.
I broke the camera! I broke the camera! You broke my film! You broke my film, you degenerate! Look, I'll kill you and your family!
I am so sorry.
You had to see that.
I'm assuming everyone has left.
Yeah, Betty didn't want to, but Dwayne was his ride. If you want to, we could try to
just leave. Right now.
Jason.
Please.
may seem like a dumb question to ask, but have you ever actually enjoyed making this movie?
No. But I have to finish it. God, I wish I made something else. Just about anything would have been better than... Oh my God. I'm blanking.
What?
I'm just blanking right now. I've literally forgotten what the hell I'm actually making. Either I'm growing a tumor or the movie I made up is so uninvesting to me. God damn.
Well, if you had the chance to go back and make something else, what would you make?
I don't know. Oh God.
What?
I had this stupid idea in my head.
Well, tell me.
No, it's something dumb. It's a romantic comedy, but the couple are two gay men.
Well, that's something.
Yeah, I'm calling it Misery Has No Genders. You got a kick out of that, didn't you?
Yeah.
Well, that's basically it, just a premise and a title.
Well, it has a lot of possibilities.
You really think so? You think it could sell?
Well, depends on how triggered people can get, but every film has an audience.
Yeah, how big of an audience, though? What do you think?
About what?
About the thing I'm trying to make right now.
You know, it sucks, but now I'm thinking of it as if... Well, what if this is me in 2 years? At least you know what you want to do with your life.
The heck does that mean?
I don't know what I want to do with my life.
Okay, first, you're a sophomore. Of course you don't know what you want to do with your life. Second, do you think I want to go into directing films after this? Hell no. Third, you are one of the most adorable, purest people I have ever met in my life. Chances are you'll get 100 jobs with your personality alone while I just get stuck in LA with a crummy desk job for 42 years because I'm a social wreck. Can you answer me something?
Probably. What is it?
How are you so good at talking with other people? Like, is there a certain mindset you have to be in? Or do I have to look something up on an encyclopedia to know what people are talking about? Or am I just overthinking stuff?
You're probably overthinking everything.
I wish I could stop overthinking everything. I wish I could stop thinking about where we're going after life, about how much time I wasted on making this movie, how I'm never gonna finish it. I wish I could just stop thinking about it all.
Then stop.
What?
Well, if you hate thinking about all that, well then why don't you just stop thinking about it all?
Because... Do you wanna go out tonight?
What?
I got this text from Benny.
Benny?
Yeah, he said he wants to do all these things on his bucket list.
Yes!
Wait, yes?
Yes, let's go out tonight!
Are you sure?
Of course!
Are you sure? Do you
Jason! Out
And there he is, Jason Millard, the man of the hour. Come here, man. Well, one of you guys has to call shotgun.
Do you
want... He'll do it.
Okay, yeah, thanks. Boy.
Hi, I'm Lydia. This is Steve, the silent extrovert, and that's Dwayne, the whiny loner.
My mom forced me to be here.
Well, Benny, I see you got your rat pack together. So how does this work? Like, are you just gonna show us what's on the list?
shoot.
What? What is it?
The final thing on the list for tonight, number 60. I don't think we can do it, guys.
No, come on, Benny.
What is it?
Oh, I'm supposed to crash at this friend's backyard, Jamie. He's got a trampoline. His family's on vacation, though.
Well, what's wrong with that? I'm sure he doesn't mind.
We should TP his house.
Wait, we don't have TP, Lydia.
We'll TP with our imagination.
Dwayne! Dwayne, help me! I'm getting out, okay.
You want to get on the trampoline?
I kind of do.
Go right ahead. Benny.
Uh-huh?
Your list is amazing.
Thank you.
You know, I gotta ask though, why do all this stuff during junior year? I mean, why don't you save some of it for senior year when it seems more appropriate?
Isn't it obvious?
Kind of.
I think I just want to put myself out there as fast as possible.
And after this, what do you plan to do for senior year?
Travel, maybe. I mean, I need to know where I'm going in life. Isn't it obvious? I mean, people don't go to school just to get good grades, isn't it?
Damn straight. What you thinking about? You can tell me.
You're the first boy I've kissed.
Well, so are you. Except you're a woman. Go on, tell me.
I'm just worried. How long is this gonna last?
Why are you thinking that?
I don't know, it just all happens so fast. I know girls who date guys who seem so sweet, and then after 2 weeks, they're sharing texts about each other behind each other's backs, and they're posting nudes, and...
Oh, hey! Do you know who you sound like right now? You sound like me from a week ago. You can get my hair cut and probably dress up for me as Halloween. Why are you thinking about all this?
I don't know, I'm just superstitious.
Well, I am too. But you said it best earlier. What's important is here and now, and just look at the here and now right in front of you. There's Lydia and Steve bouncing on a trampoline. There's Benny over there talking with Dwayne.
That's not Dwayne.
Yeah, he is. That.
No, Dwayne's right there.
Well, then who's... Shit. Hang on. Hi, mister.
Is he the leader of this?
Well, actually, I am. Look, we're sorry for busting into your house like this.
We really are.
I mean, so are you like Jamie's uncle or grandpa?
Jamie doesn't live here.
Well,
he's my neighbor.
Yeah, then what are you doing living in his house?
This is my house, you idiot.
No, it's not. Jamie lives here.
No, he doesn't.
Look, sir, this is Jamie's house. I mean, if you go in there right now, you could find a picture of him and his family.
Do you think I'm going to fall for that, you fop doodle?
Listen, sir, I don't know how this happened.
No, hang on, Benny. I'm not going to let this slide. Did you just call him a fop doodle?
You're darn right I did.
Okay. Who do you think you are, Shakespeare? What makes you think you have the audacity to use such a dated curse word like fop doodle? What gives you the right to come out here in the middle of the night and stalk us with an umbrella? Is that an umbrella?
Ow!
Jason!
Get off my property!
Everybody run to the car!
I'm gonna get you!
All right, is everyone here?
Yeah.
Okay. Where are my keys?
You mean the ones you left in Jamie's backyard?
Dwayne, why didn't you tell me?
To be honest, this is the most fun I've had all night.
God, Dwayne.
911, what's your emergency? Okay, we'll send a cop car down there right away. What's your address?
What's Jamie's address?
I know how we can get the keys. Jason, would you be willing to run across the street into those bushes to distract the guy? Well, Eliza, you go get the keys.
Sure.
Okay.
Get off
property!
You kids saw nothing. He was passed out when I got here.
Hey guys, I couldn't find the key. Oh my god.
Jeez. What do you think, Jason?
Is this how it ends? Did I just go through a whole journey of redemption just to see an old man get killed by a car?
Yeah, pretty much.
You seem to be taking this too well.
Well, we didn't really know him that well.
Yeah, and besides, I'm gonna go party with this group of cultists later this week. I mean, they could probably hypnotize it out of me or something. You wanna come?
Definitely.
How about you, Jason?
I think I'm gonna pass on that. But, if you're doing anything not as crazy that week, just let me know.
All right. Hope I'm gonna go find my keys.
It was at that moment, looking at the corpse of a depressing old man, I knew how to finish my film.
Oh, hey, Annette, how you doing? You wanna go get some food? Your hand looks bony.
Oh my god!
Come on, Jimmy. I'm all made up the way you want me to be. All pale and ruined.
When did I ever say that?
I decided to turn my so-called serious film into an absolute farce of itself. It definitely wasn't the most professional thing to do with the picture, but it was the most obvious thing to do. Hell, I could have just passed the footage I had before this revelation as some preachy, unlinear art project. I probably wouldn't have done that if I hadn't actually learned something throughout all this garbage. Now, don't quote me on this one, but I think we as a species have just become so afraid. Afraid of meeting deadlines, afraid of violence, afraid of what we do, where we're going, that if I just make a movie exploiting that, that would make adults even more worried about our society, even though they really shouldn't be. Yeah, it's definitely not bad to lament on it once in a while, but then again, happiness. It's in the dictionary, anyone can find it. That's why I actually wanted to make this movie. Not only to show people how unpansy I am, but just to show people I'm here. And judging from the loud applause that afternoon, I think they got the message. I didn't talk with a lot of other people after the show. I certainly tried to think of something to say to them, whether it was about their looks or just my movie. I didn't have a lot of positive stuff to say about that, though. As funny as the film probably was, it was still a very amateur product of mine. But, you know, who cares? As long as the audience was satisfied, I was satisfied. Because, well, praise is praise. If I had to pick the only great thing to come out of this film, it was certainly the fact that it taught me not to screw up the rest of my senior year. That goes for all you youngsters out there too. Don't screw up senior year. I know it's easy to think you're not screwing it up, but trust me, if you step back and look at yourself early, it's easy to see yourself focusing too much on these useless, grim details of the experience. And after it's all over, even if you enjoy most of it, you might think to yourself, shit, I didn't do something, this whole experience is ruined. But no, it's not. You still enjoyed it. And besides, you already did the most important thing you could have done at the time. We all do it at some point of our young lives. We talk. We laugh. We cry. We figure out who we are. We meet some friends. Meet some assholes. we learn to be mature. We just grow up. That's about the best I could really ask for.